7654. We've gone for main engine start. We have main engine start.
This is MTV in 1981.
Ladies and gentlemen, rock and roll.
And this is Video Killed the Radio Star by The Buggles. It was the very first music video shown on the new Revolutionary Channel. It helped set the tone for the channel going forward as a place for a new vision of television. Fast forward to the 1990s, and MTV wanted to shake up its vision again. It wanted to be sleek and out there. To help with this, it launched Liquid Television, an anthology animated show. Pivotally, the very first episode would introduce one of the most well-remembered cult classics that MTV ever made, Aeon Flux. Born from Peter Chong, a former animator for Rugrats who got tired of animating the stumpy bodies of the main cast, Aeon Flux is a completely different animal. The first season of Liquid Television would feature a single narrative chopped into bits of a strange and dystopian science fiction world. One where people look like this, and movements are pushed to their limit. It seems it was exactly what MTV was looking for. It was starkly different from a lot of things that were available at the time on American television. From this, more shorts, a 10-episode series, and a movie would be made. Now, I remember seeing ads for Aeon Flux when I was a kid and being freaked out by them. Seeing them as something I really shouldn't be watching.
Aeon Flux on MTV is brought to you by Gex from Crystal Dynamics, now on PlayStation and Sega Saturn.
Recently, I was on an MTV binge, and I thought of giving it a shot. It had me enraptured from the first minute. I watched all 10 episodes in a single week and was fascinated by what I was seeing and instantly fell in love. After watching the episodes on the MTV website, since I'm not getting Paramount Plus, fuck that, I got a hold of the DVD set, which has all the episodes and the shorts. As such, I thought I would discuss them, maybe expose them to someone who may never have thought to watch a show like it, like I had. I thought it would also be good to talk about the shorts and the pilot first. Afterwards, I'll talk about the episode, since that'll take a little bit more time. So relax, take a deep breath as I show you the shorts of Aeon Flux. The very first short, divided into 6 parts, is simply called Pilot. The fly being caught by Aeon's eyelashes is something I remember seeing from time to time and being a bit freaked out by. It's funny, since it sets up what Aeon Flux is all about. Yet it has nothing to do with the narrative. It slams cuts into Aeon just mowing down soldiers, which is what this first part is completely dedicated to. The music swells to show how badass Aeon is. And you start to root for her. After all, as far as we know, she's the protagonist and hero. However, this changes as we get to the second part. We see 2 soldiers dying amongst literal towers of bodies created by Aeon. The soundtrack is more moody, with a more whimsical track appearing when Aeon casually strolls by, killing more soldiers and firing off her gun. The 2 soldiers try to console each other as they die in front of each other. We even see the cleaners standing in a foot-deep pool of blood. They get to deal with the dirty work of cleaning up after Aeon, showing, you know, somebody does have to take care of this. This instantly sets up that, from another perspective, that Aeon isn't exactly a hero. After all, these 2 don't really seem like heartless brutes. We also get introduced to this gentleman, who is Trevor Goodchild, the opposite of Aeon Flux, but we'll get into that more with the actual series. The third part is more intense, as it shows off more of the combat and is way more enclosed. We also get a change in the soundtrack again to something more stark and off-putting, somewhat industrial. It also shows off how Aeon isn't exactly a great person, as we see her dumping the contents of the briefcase and sticking a grenade in it. Then we get to the fourth part, which shows Trevor again, and shows some of the more risque, that's a word I could use, aspects of Aeon Flux. We get reminded again of Aeon's mission with her looking at the map and a setup to the final part of the pilot. The fifth part shows us that the main target that Aeon is after is laying in the same bed that Trevor and the lady he was, with is laying in. We also see the explanation of the virus and the bug, which I don't think I can show here. I'm just saying, you're not gonna eat crackers after this. This is your point now if you don't want to be spoiled, so go watch the rest of it now. It's like 10 minutes in total, but here you go. So earlier, Aeon had accidentally stepped on a nail, just enough to get stuck in the boot heel. We see her moving along normally, though the camera builds tension by constantly showing how close she is to stepping on it. Until finally, she does. The final part shows Aeon actually dying, with the agency she works for just casually blowing up her body, and then torching her apartment. All the while, Trevor is celebrated as a hero with a cure found for the virus. However, this is not where it ends. You see the vaccine being dispersed, but also Aeon existing in an entirely separate plane of existence. Also this. So, you know, a little bit of a headcanon here. I personally believe that we're seeing this guy's imagination. I'm going to call it his imagination. So that was the pilot, and it really does stick out even today. Since Aeon dies and there's literally no dialogue, you're left on your own as to what exactly is going on. Also to show how pointless Aeon's mission really was in the grand scheme of things. I mean, she didn't really do much. She's not that special in her world. There are hundreds of other agents that could easily do her job. The world of Aeon Flux doesn't really matter. So after the first season of Liquid Television, a second was commissioned, and, of course, there were more standalone Aeon shorts. They would follow the same vein, but be much shorter in length, being pretty much self-contained stories. And they would also explore other ideas and other visions, especially since Aeon dying was brought into the shorts. She dies in each of the shorts in many very different ways. Peter Chong himself even said that it became less about how she'll get through it and more how she'll bite it this time. In total, 5 shorts were created. I'm going to briefly discuss some of them, but I honestly suggest you check them out first. They are not that long. They're all incredibly interesting in their own ways. War showing the many different people and perspectives of both sides that are involved in the conflicts. Gravity, which has great tension and mystery, my personal favorite. Leisure in showing creative creature design. And Aeon at her most self-absorbed. Plop. Mirror having some creative shots, kind of my least favorite. And then finally there's Tide, which is the closest these shorts get to comedy, but also a really cool perspective shot that you get to see a couple times. So in conjunction with the other bizarre shorts with Liquid Television, they were exactly what MTV was looking for. So much so that they decided to make full 22-minute episodes based on these shorts. However, that's for another time.